All right, hello again. Today, this is the continuation of the 76 shovel head FXE motor. This is going on my Frankenstein build that I got. It's going into a 55 pan frame, kind of put together, all different wonky. I went ahead and put another EV27. I love those cams. I put that in here. Steel breather. This is the one with the S&S flywheels and rods. The jugs on this were 40 over. I haven't honed them yet, which I will. Today I'm just doing putting the rings on. Already gapped them. I've got these rings gapped at 15 thousandths. They're allowed up to 25 thousandths. So I put them at the low end for my honing. So here we go. Okay, put the expander on. Put the low ring on. The oil spiral. Just kind of put it in the groove, spiral it around, pop it in. There we go. Make sure it's free turning. Top oil ring on. Always after you do it, make sure you have a nice freedom. Always make sure your expander never overlaps, always butts, but that you don't have to do anything with until when you go to put the compressor on. When you put your ring compressor on, it's always good to maybe have it in the window of the ring compressor so you can at least see it. So when you're compressing it, you can see that it's not overlapping. Second ring, these aren't marked. Some of them have dots, maybe you're marked top. These aren't. These are S&S rings that aren't marked, but the bevel, inside bevel, goes down. So second ring, put it in there. Now the top ring, also not marked. They're lighter in color. You can always tell that. These are, second ring is always dark. Kind of a blackish color. Top ring is always a lighter, kind of beige color. This one happens to be marked 40 thousandths, so any letters, that one's usually the top. Also on the S&S rings anyway. The bevel on the inside goes up on the top ring. Always use an expander, don't spiral them on. Even though rings are tough, that you can crack them, they will split. Now, once they're on, at this point, you don't need to worry about positioning. Just to show you, just quick. Now, in the bore, when the engine is running, rings do turn in the groove slightly. I don't care what anybody says, they do not spin in the groove. They do turn. They will, the gaps will kind of orient all over the place while the motor is turning. But putting them in, I like to put, personally, I'll put the top and second ring, two compression rings, I always put opposite. I'll put like 10 o'clock, 4 o'clock, and then the two oil rings, I'll put 2 o'clock and 7 o'clock. And then the expander, I'll either put at 12 or 6. It's usually a good habit to get into. I'm sure everybody has their own different ways. Just make sure you definitely put your compression rings complete opposite. That's definitely one. Even though in the bore, when it's running, they do actually ride the groove slow. They don't spin. So I've heard people on sites, I've seen comments, all kinds of silly comments where these rings spin in their grooves as it's going up and down. No, they do not. They do turn. Sometimes they actually turn back and forth. But they don't spin. Anyway, so that's it for right now on just ring placement, identification, and basically gap placement, or at least where I like to put the gaps before I put the expander. I like to put just a little bit of assembly lube on the outer part of the rings before I put my compressor on. Kind of line up the gaps where I want them. Put the put the compressor on, put the jug on, tap it on until I get all rings are inside the jug, and then just release the compressor, take it off, and then pop it down, lower it. Of course, I use Marvel Mystery Oil, coat the inside of my jugs just for easier slide, but you should do that anyway. Always coat the insides, especially after honing, otherwise you get some pitting or light rust if it sits too long. So that's it.